Yo, what it do, y'all? It's your man Mike Titan, the gaming savant, bringing y'all another episode of Titan Plays. And today we are playing The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, the brand new, newly released game for the Nintendo Switch and the Wii U. This, of course, is the Wii U version because I already had a Wii U that was collecting dust, and I didn't really see a reason for me to get a Switch just because of this one game. Also, because I think the Switch is kind of like, I'm not going to say a stupid system, but I just don't see no point in me getting it as of right now. So we went ahead and got it for the Wii U. I've been playing this game a bit. I just got to, where am I at? Hatino Village. So I'm about to go speak with the laboratory lady. I forget. Y'all got to excuse me. I'm not too well versed in the Zelda lore. So this is my character, Link. I bought the little ninja outfit that makes him look like Sheik, and then I just like colored it gray. So this is kind of cool. I wanted to color it black, but I didn't have enough materials to make it black, because you know, all black everything. But you know, this is all right. This is not bad. This is gray. I mean, he still kind of looks like a girl, but whatever. You know, it is what it is. Apples. Now, with this game, the thing about this game, I wasn't going to, Link, climb the tree, buddy. Link, why are you acting real brand new right now, bro? Just climb the tree, grab the apple. That's all I ask you to do. Link, climb the tree, thank you. Can you grab the apple? You didn't grab the apple. Okay, let's do this. I can't climb this thing either. Oh my god, this game is bugging out right now. I just want, okay, all right. That's not the arrow that I want. That's the arrow that I want. And now I wasted the arrow just to get an apple. All right. Yeah, so the thing about it was I wasn't initially going to buy this game until I started seeing people play it on Twitch the Thursday before it came out, because it came out Friday, March the 3rd. And then I started looking, and I was like, you know what, this game actually looks pretty good. The only Legend of Zeldas that I've played was Ocarina of Time and Majora's Mask, but I never beat any of them. What are these? Bomb arrows. Ooh, Jesus. Bomb arrow one. But I never beat any of them, just because I just never really got that really deep into them. I probably got about halfway through, and then I just, like, you know, didn't really beat any of them. Do I have anything to sell? Let's see. Have, like, any gems or anything? No, I think I sold all that stuff. Okay, I'm good. I kind of do need some arrows, though, but it's all right. Well, 20... Oh. Yeah. So I never beat Majora's Mask or Ocarina of Time. Yo, bruh, buy the arrows, Link. Take them all. So this is technically my first Legend of Zelda game since Majora's Mask, which was like back when 2001, maybe? Oh, that's cool how he has like the little dye colors up there. It's funny. Looks like it's about to rain in this game. But so far, I'm enjoying the game. This game will get a lot of comparisons to Horizon, just because they're kind of similar open world games. They're similar to each other, but they each have their own little quirks about them. I definitely enjoy both equally. I'm probably going to focus on beating Horizon first, just because we all know we got Mass Effect coming out in about 2 weeks, and I want to at least get one of these games beat before that game comes out. So I think I'm going to focus on Horizon first, then Mass Effect, and then I'll come back to Zelda probably once I get done, like, just beating the ever-loving crap out of Mass Effect story. Yeah. We've gathered all known literature on ancient civilizations here. As for actual number of books, well, is that thing on your waist, is that a Sheikah? There's no mistaking it, that's a real Sheikah slate, isn't it? I've never actually seen one in person. If you could show me the runes on it, I'd be most appreciative. Stasis, magnesis, yes, yes, the remote and Kronos. And what else? Let's see. That's it for runes, but strange. Looks like you don't have the basic runes. I understand why you're missing. Must be reason. Oh, where are my manners? I nearly forgot to introduce myself. My name is Simon. You are a Link, right? You know my name. Lady Impa caught me up to speed. You told a young man holding a cigarette will appear. You must do all you can to help him. She will hope to return awakens the slumber of restoration. His name will be Link. It's very important. Director, listen, Miss Director. This is the real Sheikah State Director. To our director. Right over there. Oh, I didn't even notice her over there. You know what's funny? Whenever I walked in, I thought that was like a flower or something. Oh, wow. My bad. Ancient Tech Lab Director, Miss Pura, is a world-famous authority of Hyrule culture. I'm honored to be her assistant. On that note, Link, you see the director may look like a gun girl, but, well, maybe it's not a place to tell you these things. You talk to Miss Pura yourself. Okay, cool. She could say one of the basic runes. Oh, wait. Hold on. We'll lead you there by minute sounds. Interval sounds shortens closer you get to them. To stop searching for the your object of choice, set the seeker sensor on your map to off. How the hell do I do that? Oh. Okay. So essentially whenever I get close to a shrine, which shrines in this game are kind of like one or two room dungeons. There's like 100 of them, and every 4 shrines that you complete, you get you get an orb for every shrine, and then for every 4 orbs you get, you can level up either one of your hearts, so you can add like a heart piece, or you can add more stamina, because Link uses stamina to climb stuff, paraglide, fight, stuff like that. So this shrine thing would normally like make a beeping sound every time I'm close to a shrine, but it's hella annoying whenever you like know where a shrine is at and you're by it. And the thing is still like, hey, there's a shrine nearby. And I'm like, well, I already know there's a shrine nearby. I just like am just exploring for a second. So you can turn it off, but then again, that won't tell me where there are shrines nearby. So I have to manually look for them. I'll keep it on for now. I wish there was a way that you could just like switch it to rumble. Cause what it does is like it rumbles your controller and then it starts doing the sound. If there was a way that it would just like continuously rumble your controller, that would be kind of cool. But you know, whatever. It's a video game. All right, let's talk to Miss Pura? Pura? Director of the laboratory is not Simon, it's me. Snippity snap. Oh hell, what the, okay. Anyway, Linky, wow. Do you remember any dreams from your time in the restoration? You don't look like you've changed a bit in the last 100 years, but something must have happened in all that time. No matter what, I'm happy to see you're still in one piece, Linky. What's all look? You still remember, you don't? I don't remember you. Well, I'm shocked. You don't know if you'll be able to recover from all this, even though 100 years ago I took you to the Shrine of Resurrection after Calamity Ganon fatally wounded you. Even though I was one who put you safely in the slumber of restoration, despite all that, you still don't remember me? Nah, no. It's called amnesia for a reason, woman. Bad habit taking notes abruptly like that. It's a charming quirk, isn't it? Do you have any questions? Aren't you a child? How very rude. The truth is, I look this way because of a failed experiment. I would say failed, but in some ways a success. I documented the full affair in my diary upstairs, but the whole thing is embarrassing. Okay, I'll just go read your diary in a second then. Topic at hand, after 100 years, here to defeat Calamity Ganon, who was growing in strength every past moment, and to rescue our beloved Princess Zelda. Cheers to try. I need restore the desserts. Sure, why not? Yeah, I mean, you wanted me to save Zelda and fight Ganon, but you want me to do shit for you. I don't understand. It's like, hey, I can do something that can help you go save the world, but first I need you to do something for me. It's like, don't you think me saving the world is like kind of trumps you, like me? Okay, whatever. Homo. Could you please bring a blue frame from the ancient furnace in town? Also, use it to light up the furnace. The sweet guidance stone will start working once in the missing runes. Okay, I can do that. So I just gotta go into town and get a fire of some sorts? Okay. Wait a minute. Yo, is there? This ladder doesn't go anywhere. Wow, I am shocked that I fell for that. Wait, she said there was an upstairs somewhere. No, there's not an upstairs somewhere. What the freak is your diary at? I kind of want to know what happened with the experiment and why you're a little girl. Am I missing something? Maybe it's over here. No, that takes me outside. Nothing on the wall, nothing in there, nothing in there. Nothing in there. Okay, whatever, I'll come back and do it. So I need to go. What is that? Is that it? No, that's I don't know what that is. I guess that's it. Anyways, Avanti! This paragliding thing is like pretty badass. It would be even more badass if he could do like one-handed tricks. Kind of like SSX tricky, but like with paragliding. That would be freaking awesome. You know, he just like lazily hovers down to the ground. Link, battler of evil and part-time arsonist. She'll never know what happened. The Hatino Agent Lab is now set as a travel gate. Nice. Oh, that was... Was that hurting me? Okay. All right, woman, I've done your deed. Fix my slate thingy. Give me a nice snap. Go on. No time to be shy about it. Nah, I'm good. Oh, wait, I have to... Oh, I gotta... God damn it. I didn't realize I actually had to, like, say snap. I thought I could just be like, nah, just fix my stuff for me. Sheikah Slate Authenticated. Camera, Hyrule, compendium, and album file was missing, confirmed. Starting repair. Okay, so I'm gonna get like a camera mode, so I'll be able to get like a filter and everything. Get a Hyrule filter. Oh, this is like a logbook. Okay, so it's like show all the creatures that I've fought and everything. Hopefully. Can I take a picture with this bitch? I don't even know how to use the picture. Uh-oh. Thank you. Really? Go on these images. Yes, there are some old landscape photos stored in the album. I know Princess Zelda had a frequent use of the camera feature, but this dawns that you were Princess Zelda upon a night, which means that you can accompany her to all these pages. Blah, 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 blah. Don't lose hope. This means these pictures could be missing the piece that helped restore the lost memories. I suggest you check in with Impa, see if more. She knows I do. You don't have to worry about this till after Impa, but bring back some ancient materials. Either bring me to Robbie at the Akala Ancient Tech Lab. If you bring us ancient materials, we'll give you some good reward. I think I have some ancient materials. Oh, I don't have all that? I know I got some screws. I have ancient spring. Ah, that's what it is. I have an ancient spring. Robbie's research? Okay. And I fly right in this. Hell yeah. Excuse me, lady. Her appeal was giving you a runaround, but you seem just fine. Damn, how does word travel that quickly? Oh. This camera survived over 100 years. So some of your lost memories come back once you've tried at least one of those locations. That's something I wish to give you. Okay. So how the how the hell am I supposed to know what these positions are? Y'all not gonna give me like a map or anything? Okay, you know what? Screw it. Let's go do Robbie's research. Since the game was gonna be like, hey, go to this place, even though you've never been there before. Actually, yeah, we'll fast travel back here. No, looks like we done found us a goat. Hey, Mr. Goaty. That's right, just sit there. It'll all be over in a second. Fuck, I missed. Oh, that is high up there. Damn, okay. This may take a little bit more than I thought to try to get up there. Really, you again? I really hate how easily weapons break in this game. That's like my one main gripe in this game, is just like how easy the weapons just break. It's like I get why they're doing it, but it's just like annoying and super duper tedious. Actually, I can just climb up here and do that. Ow. Ow. Oh, you know, how about y'all just hold this? I wasn't paying attention to my health. This is why I should probably start investing in health whenever I get the next couple of orbs. Just because of that. I think I'm good on stamina for now. I was not paying attention to my health at all. I'm not even gonna lie about that. Y'all started me all the way back here? Really? Really? Autosave? Okay, yeah, I'm not gonna go do all that again. All right, that's gonna do it for today's video. Moral of the story, kids, make sure to save before you go do anything stupid and just like randomly gallivant around a place that you're not that familiar with. And also watch your health, because when you get a lot of enemies in this game, the combat is cool, but it's not really made for fighting more than one enemy at a time. So as you can see, when I got wrecked, because I wasn't paying attention, because I had like three enemies, which I could have easily taken down, but I just wasn't paying attention to my health. This is what happens. Typically, the autosave is pretty good about like saving you. Maybe it's because I haven't, because y'all know I was going to the tower in that area. I haven't unlocked like the tower in that area, so I haven't unlocked like the map of that area yet. That's probably why I didn't autosave me there. But still, it's like, okay. All right, it is what it is. But I want to thank everybody for watching. Please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. It's your man, Mike Titan, and I'm out this piece. Go.